Hi, my name's Jerry. I've owned this 47 Merc for 10 years. The car came from Fresno, California. That's where it was born. It's currently registered. I have the California pink slip and the ownership. This is an old school rod. It's what I wanted to build. When I bought the car, it had a full race flathead in it. Trouble, trouble, trouble. Nothing but trouble. I'm selling the car because I have an ongoing health issue. That's why I'm all yellow. 2 years ago, I took the car to Jim McLaughlin Restorations. It was there a year. He stripped all the paint to bare metal, put sealing primer, and black Lincoln paint. I can't believe the price of the paint. This car is absolutely laser straight. All the fenders were taken off, everything done, painted. was $6,000 for that. He put in all new glass and rubber seals, had everything on the car re-chromed. All the stainless on the car is de-dinged and polished. That cost me a ton. All this side stainless, all this chrome, this, everything, all done. All around here, the rubber seals are done. I even had the hubcaps, the original hubcaps, de-dinged and polished. Now they should be painted in there, you know, with black mercury in there. Come around the back, John. I had 47 Merc plates restored, and they're registered to the car, right there. I have the front one in there, I'll show you. All the window frames are powder coated. My son-in-law here put really good electric wipers in the car that work. Trying to think what else here. Got plenty of stuff. Let's go look at what we got in here. This car is drop dead gorgeous. Look at the quarters on it. They're laser straight. The fenders, everything. Laser straight. New rubber is around here. Car is gorgeous. Over here, I have stuff that goes with the car. These spears are so hard to come by, and they haven't been welded or anything. And they go right here. That's the very last thing that's done. Right there they go. They cost me a lot of money. I have original Ford wipers and arms. This is the front license plate, never been on the car. I've got West Coast mirrors that go on the car if you want. I've got other Swan mirrors and all new I'll throw in with the car. Here's turn signals if you want those. Here's the radio delete plate that goes in the dash. This is the California title, which I signed, and the registration, 2013. I want to explain about the interior. I've got the door panels for the car, but they're all old school. Got the kick pads and stuff, and the seats are in good shape. I was going to redo the whole thing and recover the whole thing, but I just run out of gas. Can't do it. All the lights work on the car. Oh, here's the wipers. Uh, had the dash painted. I put E-gauges in here that work real good. Then I took the speedometer and had that rebuilt and silk screened to match these gauges. And I had the clock the same way, rebuilt with a quartz movement, silk screened to match the gauges. Radio delete plate goes in here. I showed you that. If you want to put a radio. Horn works. I wanted to make sure I hooked it up to the column. All the gauges work. Thanks for holding it. I didn't hook up the amp gauge because I didn't want to. I ran the wire from the alternator right down to the starter lug, but you could run it in here and loop it around. I don't want to do that. But anyhow, that's what it is. This is park. I have no neutral safety switch on it. This is park. If you want to put one on, be my guest. Car sure runs good. It's got the exhaust system from the flathead with the Smitty mufflers. Really cool. Let me show you what's under the hood here. By the way, it's got tube shocks all around. Not those stupid lever action shocks. Put the Harry and Ginny's hood lifter set up in here. Best thing you could do. Get rid of that old Ford crap and junk. That's ridiculous. I guess I should have wiped this down a little bit, huh? But anyhow, put a new radiator in it a year or so ago. Boy, was that expensive. Put electric fan on it. The horns are up here. And the transmission cooler is right here. Now here's the story with the engine. My buddy had a show, 56 Chevy Bel Air, and he wanted to upgrade the motor and the transmission. So he gave me his 265. That's what it is, 265. What I did, I got it home, I checked it all out, redid the heads just in case, and they were on the verge, but the car runs good, everything's fine. Then, I called up our local hot rod transmission guy and had him build me a Turbo 350 stock. Little extra clutches, no shift kit, stock. So Ron came out to the house, brought the built transmission, brought a really high-class starter out with him, and a torque converter, and we had the engine on my bench. So we put it together and shimmed everything, torqued everything, shimmed the starter, got it perfect. And gave me a 2-year warranty on it. And that's the transmission. It works perfect. I had Drive Lines Unlimited make me a drive shaft. I got the Speedway open drive line kit and put it all together. Now what has to be done, and I'm out of gas, I can't do it. The pinion has to be adjusted. But under an hour's job, should do it on a lift. You got to pull the drive shaft down, the aluminum housing down. There's a pin in the universal, take that out. And there's two nuts. I'm going to give you an original Ford manual with it, and you'll see what to do. You just tighten them up till the pinion gear stops shaking, and it's perfect. And had the rear end rebuilt a couple of years ago, new bearings and gears, and that's okay. Brakes work real good. It needs a speedometer cable. I got the guy that'll make the cable for $70, and he'll make it to the car, turbo trans to Ford to Mercury Speedo. I'd like to show you the trunk before we're done, and then. See this? So you don't get killed with that falling on you. What we need to do, I need to get the tie down for this. I don't have it right now, but I'll get the tie down for that. The battery, here's the kick pads for the front. There's all the door handles. What a cool way I mounted the battery. I put new cardboards, a new floor mat. I bolted this to the trunk, put a ground underneath to the frame, grounded this to the battery box, and I put other grounds on the car. Zero problem with that. But the trunk is good. There's no rust. Whoops, oh, I thought that was coming down. Okay. There's no rust on this car whatsoever, never has been. And that's pretty much it. Electric fuel pump. That's pretty much it. It's really a nice car. Shows well. But get that pinion adjusted. No, at the most, an hour's labor. I'll throw the book in there. I just didn't get around to do it. And the Speedo cable. And the interior, and brother, you got a real high-end car. Okay, thanks a lot. If you want to, I want you to contact me on email, chapjerry, chapjerry, at yahoo.com. Send me its phone number, and I'll call you back. I don't want phone calls in the middle of the night from Australia. Okay, I'll call you back. And I'll work with you, brother, I'll work with you, and we'll get it done. Okay, thanks a lot for looking.